customer asked me to fix their kid's Nintendo Switch.
But will I be able to?
Who knows?
Let's find out.
This video has been sponsored by PCBWay.
I'm gonna get my tester here, and we're gonna test this Switch real quick. Right, so it's charging, but it only charges when I let it hang. If I just... even if I set it on the desk, it doesn't charge anymore. So we definitely have a connector issue here. Looking at it, I'm pretty sure that the connector is wobbling a little bit, and I think it's completely been nipped off the motherboard, probably by someone trying to, you know, force it to charge by twisting and turning. And, you know, if I try to turn it on, I actually turn it off. And at that point, it draws around 0.1 amps. And if I turn it back on, this happens. I'm gonna turn it off again. Now it's 0.1 amps again. If you look at the connector, you can really see that it's split open. I think I see a lifted pin inside, but I'm gonna check under the microscope. Right, you can actually see the lifted pin. It's a golden leg that's kind of sticking out. And even if this gave us consistent charging already, I would probably change it anyway. Time to take the motherboard out. Right, so apparently the heatsink was crushed. A little fin came off. Wow, the connector is absolutely... oh God. So, the connector is actually garbage right now. It's completely disordered. I don't think anything is holding it down at all. Maybe a few pins. Here, the leg has completely snapped. Here, the leg is still here, but the solder has completely been chewed up, so it's free moving. The legs are still here, but the solder is not doing anything anymore. I'm gonna do just one test. I'm gonna see if I can find any shorts around M92. The CPU cap is okay. This capacitor is shorted. Okay, there's clearly something still holding it. So I'm just gonna do a little bit of some... Okay, so the port has just fallen off on its own. I'm gonna do the flip. I really don't wanna, but I have to. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. Oh, damn. Holy f... I don't have to do anything. I mean, let's just take a look. Let's just verify. So this pin is broken, but it's still here. And the pad is still here. The pad is all right. The pad is alright, the pad is alright, the pad is alright, the pad is alright.
La piazzola sta bene!
So we don't have to do anything anymore here on the port. We're just gonna need to slap a new one on. That is actually quite impressive, honestly. I never seen anything like this, even from videos online. Let's just put a new port on, shall we?
But first, a moment for today's sponsor.
If you need a printed circuit board, PCBWay has everything you need. They pride themselves on having the best value, fast turnaround, and one-on-one assistance. Just tell them some basic values like the dimensions and the quantity of your PCB, and you can get an immediate quote. After that, you can change things like the amount of layers your PCB has, the material it's made of, and even the color. They have many colors, but I especially like matte black. Sign up today following the link in the video description and get a $5 welcome bonus.
So I'm gonna turn on my fume extractor because I don't wanna die.
If you wanna get into this type of work, I have a link to all my tools in the video description, together with my Patreon page and my Discord server. Now all that's left to do is to prepare the board for the new port by thinning all the pads. I also like to clear the mounting holes for the port, and then we just install it. This is actually a very tricky installation to do because the port has two rows of pins and one row is hidden. So you have to install it blindly without any chance to touch them up with the iron afterwards. And so if you fail, you need to either remove the port and place it back again, but sometimes you can just get away with the reflow. This is a component called M92T36 and has some shorts around it, so I'm gonna try removing it and see if it helps. Sadly, that didn't help at all.
Now I'm thinking that since it was at 15 volts charging, there's a very high chance that M92 is actually alright. So what I'm thinking is that it's probably Pi-3 on the other side that is damaged, because that also can prevent the switch from charging. So I'm gonna use the same solder that was on the board because I don't really need to change it. I'm just soldering the old piece back in place. Let's check for shorts around Pi-3. So we have this one is shorted, so I'm thinking this is probably Pi-3 being bad. The short is gone. So we know that it was Pi-3. So one thing we have left to do is to fix the heatsink. I'm gonna do that under the microscope.
Now, I know that the short is gone. I'm just gonna put the board in enough to test it. So if we fixed it, when we try to power it on, we should get the Nintendo logo. And we don't get anything. Let's try to charge it. Maybe the battery is low. There we go. The battery was low. The video is over. Check out these other two videos and hope you're happy.